our district, like many districts, struggled with our suspension rates. Compared to state and county averages, we were way high.
Suspension is kind of traumatic. When you think about a suspension, a kid is being asked to not come to school, and when they return, they might feel like the school doesn't like them or doesn't want them there anymore. And at the moment of suspension, the family might feel that the school didn't do enough.
Parents dread hearing about, hey, your student got suspended today, or your student got in trouble today. And in my experience, over time, they start to feel a little bit of anxiety when they see their phone ringing with the school phone number on it.
The only way we're going to make a difference is if we connect with the parents. And oftentimes, we invite them to our schools, but they can't make it.
When Steve Quillo became the director of student services, he noticed that our attendance rates were pretty good because of a Model SARB program. Integral to the Model SARB program is home visits.
We saw the impact it had on attendance, so why wouldn't it have an impact on kids who are suspended?
Out of those conversations, we thought the best thing that we can do is to really go into the homes.
There's two ways to lower suspensions. One is to tell the assistant principal to stop suspending kids, but then the other one is to help kids to make better decisions. And RISE is the latter.
RISE stands for Restorative Interventions Supporting Empowerment. And we start the restorative process in the home.
It all starts with the phone call that Mr. McPhee makes. He asks for permission to come out to the home, and he explains to the family why it is that we're coming.
We provide resources. It's a beautiful experience because getting to know their family dynamic, getting to know what they may need more resources for, is very helpful for us as well to see what we can provide.
Sometimes our students lack the ability to really express verbally what's happening, but we see it behaviorally. And so we see some of the acting out taking place, which is why when we go out and we meet with the students, everything is tailored specifically for that student and for the family.
We provide resources, and we also work a lot with the community. So it includes not only therapy, but we do circles.
Every time I get mad so fast, she has like something ready for me, like clay to make, coloring pages, stuff like that.
What we're doing is we're saying, hey, what can we do to further support you? What can we do to further get to know you and your child?
We are now hearing and learning just how impactful and helpful it is to identify those needs and know how to support those students.
It made me feel good because I was able to calm myself down, be a better person than what I used to be.
We have a team of 30 therapists with 4 supervisors, fully licensed. And to be able to have that resource, to be able to reach kids that are in need, is tremendous. And LCAP has afforded us that.
By using LCAP funds to help address the mental health crisis in our community, we are making school a place that students do not dread to come to.
So, and the data speaks for itself. Our attendance is doing better. Our suspension rate is going down.
Well, I really believe and I'm confident that what we're doing is, one, it's good for kids, good for families. And because of that, we're going to see successes in it.